Welcome back to Let's Code. Today we're talking about Sycamore, continuing our investigation of Rust UI frameworks, especially when it comes to WASM and the web. Sycamore says it is a couple of different things. One is that this will be fast. They don't really specify what they mean by that. They basically just say Rust and WebAssembly equals fast, which just from that description, you should feel skeptical of. They also say it's ergonomic and intuitive. Write code that feels natural. Again, intuitive is kind of a matter of what you're used to. So if you have been writing JavaScript for a decade, then you will find JavaScript pretty intuitive, or JavaScript-like things pretty intuitive. If you've been writing HTML and CSS for a decade, you'll find those pretty intuitive. But if you went and you wrote a completely different language, like R or something, you would not find that intuitive at all. So they continue and say everything is built on reactive primitives without a cumbersome virtual DOM. They don't mention what they mean by cumbersome in respect to a virtual DOM. So I think they just mean the whole concept of a virtual DOM. I think that that statement has to prove itself in the current age of web frameworks. I think that the biggest JavaScript-based web frameworks that I'm aware of use virtual DOMs. So to say that you have something better than that is kind of a statement that you have to prove, but they don't include anything on this page talking about any of these points in more depth. So just be aware that this is how they're marketing it. And they also say no JavaScript. Had enough of JavaScript? So have we. This is the only part that I really have a problem with. Marketing your thing as the anti-other thing, or as like, say, oh, do you hate that? Well, then you should use us. That's not communicating the value of the thing that you've built and saying what kind of problems that your thing solves for people. You're just saying, hey, if you don't like that, you could use this instead, right? So I would like to see them take that third one off and talk more about the benefits of using Rust and WASM rather than saying, hey, if you hate JavaScript, come over here. Because I don't feel like that's a sustainable way to build a community over long term. And it makes me more nervous than not. Like, for example, if I'm going to need to integrate with some of the JavaScript ecosystem, am I going to be able to do that in Sycamore? They've listed on the homepage that you don't have to touch a single line of JavaScript, but can I if I need to? You know, that's the question, the kinds of questions that pop up in my head. So I'd like to see them less anti other thing and more, this is what we provide. So in relation to JavaScript frameworks, Sycamore is probably most closely related to SolidJS. So you should see a bunch of SolidJS kind of idioms popping up. If we hop over to the book, it tells you how to install and then shows a hello world. So we'll go over those. They have a little bit of a CSS issue with their book or their docs or whatever. So I'm going to zoom this in to something that might be a little bit too big, I think, just to get rid of that. Of course, you have to add the WASM target using RustUp. They, as mentioned later in this book, they are very modern is the way that I'll frame it. They don't support many older Rust toolchains because they try to use features that are present in newer Rust toolchains that make it easier to write code in the way that they want to write code when you come to like writing out your HTML and things like that. So they support a minimum of 1.63 right now as of the recording of this video. That is one version back. So 1.63 and 1.64 are out right now. 1.65 is coming out this week. You also have to use Rust Edition 2021, which you probably are using anyway if you're starting a new project. Sycamore is another project that uses Trunk. So we used Trunk for you as well. So I already have Trunk installed, so I'm not going to do this, but Trunk is kind of like a development server, webpacky kind of thing for the Rust WASM front-end ecosystem. They tell you that you can use Sycamore in Cargo Toml, like it is published to crates.io, but they do mention quite specifically, and they try to push you to using a Git dependency these days. So just be aware of that if you're trying to use Sycamore in some project. You're probably going to want to track their main branch rather than tracking their crates.io release. So moving on to the Hello World example, this is the sort of smallest Sycamore application that you can produce, I believe. We pull in the Sycamore prelude. A lot of crates have preludes these days. If you're not familiar with a prelude, it's just a bunch of things that the Sycamore team considers pretty useful, or useful for the 80% of applications that are going to be produced. So you could import everything manually, but this is fine. We have a main function, and we have Sycamore render, and Sycamore render is a closure that takes a context, which is where all the reactive stuff comes through. We use a view macro, which is also going to be used quite often. You do have to pass this context to every view macro. So anytime you use view, you also have to pass the context. It feels a little awkward that you have to do that because we're already using macros here, right? If we're already using this macro and this macro already has access to CX, why do we have to pass it in ourselves here? And also this syntax here is neither Rust nor HTML, but rather some third thing. So you're going to have to get used to that as well. We've got this view macro and it opens with a curly brace, and then you've got this context argument, and then you can write like a paragraph tag with some children. And this paragraph tag with some children is pretty understandable, right? Like it's a P tag, and then whatever is inside of it is children. In this case, it's just text. So given this HTML file and that application, if we do a trunk serve, we should get a Sycamore application running in the browser. So finishing up for today, I just want to say that there are a couple things to point out here. One is that there is a Gitpod template, which will get you started with a Sycamore single page application on gitpod.io. There is also, because I mentioned JavaScript at the start of the video, a page in the documentation called JavaScript Interop. Now it is basically just a key to, hey, go look at Wasm BindGen if you want to interact with JavaScript stuff, but it is notable that Sycamore is built on Wasm BindGen and that you can interrupt with JavaScript should you need to. Sycamore also has the concept of a router. This comes in the Sycamore router crate, so we'll probably have another video going over that. And then there's also server-side rendering capabilities. So there are higher level frameworks on top of Sycamore. I think one of them is called Perseus, if I'm remembering correctly. But there are server-side rendering frameworks, things that are analogous to Nuxt or Next or whatever your server-side rendering framework of choice is in JavaScript. So overall, we didn't see a lot of the reactivity in the hello world, so we'll have to dive into that again. We didn't see a lot of JavaScript interop or routing. We also want to take another look at SSR or a larger example, something like the to-do MVC example, like we did with you, so you can compare what we did with you and what that looks like to develop in against Sycamore and what it looks like to develop in Sycamore. But that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I will see you in the next one. Have a great day.